next representation is three address code. So for example, you can see here the source language expression. Say somebody, you know, you have written some expression in your programming, you know, source language x plus y multiplication z. Okay, in three address instruction, what happens, you know, we split this into smaller part, you know, one operation per instruction is what happens in three address code. So here you can see y multiplication z is one part. So y multiplication z is calculated first, that result is stored in a temporary variable, say t1. This variable may be, you know, created by the compiler itself. Okay, and then we have to do what? So this part actually became t1. So what operation remain in our hand is x plus t1. So x plus t1 we do, and we store in another temporary variable, say t2. Okay, so t2 gives us the final result. So this is what is called three address code. Why it is called three address code? One of the reason is that it uses three identifier usually, or three different addresses, right? So two addresses provides you, or rather three times it accesses the address, you can see memory. Okay, so two of them for accessing the left operand and right operand, and the third one to store the result. Okay, so this unraveling of multi-operator arithmetic expression and nested flow of control statements. Okay, so it is basically used and important for multi-operator arithmetic expression, one thing, and if you have nested statement, flow control of nested statement, like, you know, many times we have like this if, then inside if, then else, then in else you may have again some if, and so on, right? So there can be nested things, okay, for which we need simplification, right? So this simplification can be done easily by using three address code. So three address code desirable for target code generation and optimization. Okay, so this three address code desirable for generation of the final target code and even optimization of the code. Okay, so if you look at here, this is our DAG we have constructed previously, right? So a three address code, in three address code there is at most one operator at the right side of the instruction. Okay, and three address code is linearized representation of a syntax tree or a DAG. Okay, so if you have a DAG or syntax tree, you can just represent or convert it to three address code. Okay, if it may happen that a DAG is given and you need to convert it to three address code. Okay, so in which split names correspond to the interior nodes of the graph. Okay, so if you see, you know, this part B minus C, so creates a temporary variable T1 which stores the result of B minus C. Okay, so this became T1. Then we need to multiply A with T1, right? So this becomes a temporary variable T2 which stores this multiplication. Then we add, right, another A. So this again we introduce another temporary variable T3 which does A plus T2, right? Then Here we need to multiplication for the other part, right? We need to multiply this t1 with this d. So we store this temporary result in t4. Okay, it happens. Then we need to add this t3 and t4 together, and we store the result into, say, t5. Okay, so that happens here. So what happened? How we converted this DAG to three address code? For each of this node, we have put a temporary variable. Understand? So very simple thing. Okay, if you have a DAG, you can definitely construct a three address code for it without doing any mistake. Only thing is that you have to assign these temporary variables for each of the node in the DAG. Understand? For leaf, you don't need to have, you know, leaves are already variables. Okay. Now, an address can be one of the following. Okay. It can be name. So when we are saying a three address code, what is this address here? So it can be some name. It can be some constant. It can be some compiler generated temporary variable, like, you know, T1, T1, T2, T3, T4, all these things. Right. So all these things can be treated as address here. So from three forms of three address code instruction, you can see here, I'm not going to decode this, okay, because we don't have that much time. Okay, so here is another example. You know, do I equal to I plus one while I is less than P. So this can be rewritten like this. So in C, I think we all have done this kind of thing when we have learned C programming. Okay, I don't know for everybody, at least in our time and when I have taught C languages. So many times I used to give assignment which are basically given something like a do while loop things, and you rewrite this code without using any loop. Okay, so that time what we used to do, we had to use label and go to. Okay, using label and go to, we can generate the same effect of a loop. Okay, so that is what is happening here. So we are declaring level L here, and we are going to rewrite this instruction into three address code form. So first, what is there? I plus one. So we take a temporary variable t1, which stores the result of I plus one. Then this result need to be assigned to I. So I equal to t1 we do. Okay. Then t2 is I into 8. Okay. So this we do. So this is a needed reason is that this in this array, we need to, step ahead to the next variable. AI is increased, right? So 8-bit representation is there, we're assuming in the array. Okay, so we need to step ahead with 8-bit. So we do this. Okay, then T3 takes, you can see this T2 we have calculated, this, the element at T2th location in the array A. We store it into T3, then we check if T3 less than B, then go to level L. Okay, that means it create the loop. Okay, so this becomes the symbolic level of it. Okay, now position level is also created corresponding to this. So these are the memory position. Okay, in the stack, if you are using stack. Okay, so here you can see this level L is no more L, it become, the memory location 100, where this instruction is there, it becomes the 100th line of instruction. So it go to 100, or it is the, it's a memory address location 100 given by, address location given by 100. So it is going to this 100th address location. Okay, so this is what happens. Basically, this L will represented, replaced by address when your code is going to be executed on the system. Okay,